नमस्कार, राज्यसभा टीवी में आपका स्वागत है। मैं हूं आलोक मेहता और आज हम बात करने जा रहे हैं जाने माने संपादक, प्रबंध निदेशक मलयालम मनोरमा के मामन मैथ्यू जी से, जो दुनिया का पांचवा सबसे बड़ा अखबार है। मामन जी नमस्कार।
नमस्कार,
नाइस टॉकिंग टू यू। आफ्टर लॉन्ग टाइम वी आर मीटिंग। नाइटर्स गिल्ड, यू आर प्रेसिडेंट, यू हैव पद्मश्री ऑल्सो, एंड यू हैव ए वेरी बेस्ट ट्रेडिशन ऑफ द इथिक्स ऑफ द जर्नलिज्म, व्हाट वी यूज टू टॉक इन एडिटोरियल फ्रीडम एक्सप्रेशन। सो फर्स्ट आई वुड लाइक टू वॉन्ट टू नो फ्रॉम यू द रूट्स ऑफ द मलयालम मनोरमा, द ट्रेडिशन फ्रॉम फ्रीडम स्ट्रगल डेज।
हेलो जी, फर्स्ट लेट मी थैंक यू। वी आर ओल्ड फ्रेंड्स, वी वर्कड इन द एडिटर्स गिल्ड टुगेदर फॉर अ वेरी लॉन्ग टाइम and our friendship started from there. My respect for you as an editor itself, as a good journalist, started during our Editors Guild association. Malayala Manorama was founded in 1883 by Kandathil Varghese Maple, a poet. He was a poet. This was not started as a commercial establishment. Malayala Manorama, now to choose the name Malayala Manorama itself, he called all the poets of Travancore, princely Travancore state, to come and participate in a brainstorming to name the newspaper which he had in mind. Normally, those days, there was no system of brainstorming. Normally, an owner says, I will name my newspaper so and so. Many have changed their names. Our name is Malayala Manorama. Malayala Manorama, Manorama means, in Malayalam we say, Manasine Remepikua. That means
happiness,
happiness of the mind. Happiness, jo kush dete hain man ko, that is really the thing. Now, this name was not selected by Kandathil Varghese Maple. It was selected at this brainstorming session by Kerala Varma Valya Koi Tamburan of the royal family of Travancore. Vilvittatha Raghavan Nambiar. Actually, it is Mr. Raghavan Nambiar who selected the name Malayala Manorama, which we subsequently knew that when Mr. Raghavan Nambiar passed away, Malayala Manorama had a front page saying, the person who baptized us, who gave us the name, is no, alas, no more. He also wrote the horoscope of Malayala Manorama.
Initially it was fortnightly.
Initially it was a weekly. It came out on Saturdays. It came out. So now after this was Malayala Manorama was named, you have to take royal permission to start. So Kandathil Varghese Maple was a very eminent poet. Went to the Maharaja of Travancore and told him that this is what we have started. He was so delighted by this name, you know, that he gave the Travancore royal coat of arms, that is two elephants and all, he gave that as a present to Malayala Manorama to be used as our logo. Oh. To be used as our logo. In which it says, charity our household divinity, which means dharmosmata kula devata. That is also part of, we modified it a little bit and started it. It was Sri Moolam Tirunal, the Maharaja of Travancore, who gave us the royal coat of arms. So it started never as a commercial establishment, because our founder, at the age of 21, worked for a newspaper called Kerala Mitram in Cochin, which was owned by a Gujarati called Mr. Devji Bhimji.
Yeah.
He used to work there at the age of 21. So he left Kerala Mitram because he had to travel by boat for 1 week to reach Cochin from his native place in Alappi district. So he had to come. So then, when he was 31, he started Malayalam Manorama. So now, there also there is a little bit of, you know, enterprise shown by him. See, those days, literature was in a stage, in a state of intoxication. It was the ripe time for a lot of literary activities. It was not a commercial thing, which I always say.
But must be the social issues, the political
social issues. In fact, it was started. Then he ordered the press. Now people paid 100 rupees. 100 persons paid 100 rupees and started some in 4 or 5 installments and all that. With the first installment, he bought a press, a treadle press from London, Hopkinson and Cope, which is, you know, you print one side, yeah, you put ink, turn it the other way. And Malayala Manorama was started on, was registered as the first joint stock publishing company in India on March 14th, 1888. Mm-hmm. But for 2 years, he had to simplify the Malayalam. Malayalam type had 600 characters at that time. Diphthongs, the vowels, the consonants, 2 letters, 3 letters, then the various symbols and the combination of all those symbols and all that. So he got a local craftsman to make the types, mm-hmm, to suit this press. So he was involved in the enrichment of the language itself. So he halved it from 600 characters to almost 300 characters, and later on did it. So 2 years delay was there in the actual starting of the press. Starting of the press was, of the newspaper, was on 1890, March 22nd. The reason why March 22nd, week from the town of Kottayam, there was one, a cattle fair. So, it must have like a mela, you know, it's a cattle fair. Two, was a temple festival at the main Tirunakkara Maidanam in Kottayam. To symbolize that, we started off. It was very, right from day one, he was assisted by K.C. Mammen Mathew, who was my grandfather. Kandathil Varghese Mapla's brother's son was K.C. Mammen Mathew. He was preparing to sit for the Indian Civil Service examination. So he told him, being the uncle, you come and join. From day one, K.C. Mammen Mathew was involved with the newspaper from 1890. K.C. Mammen Mathew writes about the thrill of the first issue coming up, the ink falling on his hands, how much of, what a thrill it was. He was doing the binding, folding, distribution, and he was a voracious, he had just taken a degree from Madras Christian College and come back to Kerala. So, if you see the line of chief editors of Malayala Manorama, they are all connected with literary. I am the fifth chief editor in 127 years. Maybe I am the person who's got the least amount of poetic sort of capabilities.
But at that time, must be Britishers. How
it was British.
What were the reactions?
Now, the very first issue of Malayala Manorama, the editorial was really very revolutionary. It called, Kandathil Varghese Maapiala wrote that that children of the Pulaya caste, that is those days what we used to call the Dalits, should be given education. Those days education was only for the upper class, the princely class. But it should, that was the, imagine what a great editorial to write that education should be given to the, we could have written about so many other subjects, but he chose a revolutionary plan. Kandathil Varghese Maapiala always used to have Kavi Sabhas, Bhasha Bhoshani Sabha,
poetry festival.
Bhasha Bhoshani is a literary magazine which we've gotten. So he used to always sit round and have poets and all.
But so, he was also active in the politics, in Congress or something?
Kandathil Varghese Maapiala was not involved in politics. My grandfather was involved in setting up of the state Congress at that time. And so you must realize his basic interest was to write literature. He was a voracious reader. He used to write in Malayalam and in English with equal ease, no problem. Malayalam, he was very good. And when some subjects were of interest or which upset him, he used to sit and write editorials, that is my grandfather, which were so strong, hard-hitting, and at the same time lengthy, explaining both sides, you know.
That's why the Britishers must be annoyed, and then they just, you have to stop the publication of the...
I would like to correct you, Alokji. The Britishers had nothing to do with this.
Okay.
It was actually the Diwan of the Travancore. Maharaja, I don't want to take his name, I mean we've forgotten all those past things. He was from Tamil Nadu. He and my grandfather, they were friends initially, both were brilliant. It's like diamond cutting diamond. Finally, they fell out. And there
he
was
must be more loyal than the king, what we
yes.
always say.
Yes, he was very loyal. He was very close to the royal family. I don't think the royal family as such wanted to. There was a firing incident near Trivandrum at a place called Nayyatingara, where some police people of the Maharaja and I think 6 or 7 persons died. We reported it that evening itself. The Diwan sent and closed Malayala Manorama, and after some time arrested my grandfather and took him to Trivandrum jail. In fact, took him to Trivandrum jail, and he found my grandfather to be a little bit of a problem person even in jail. That he finally transferred him to Madras Central Jail. Every time I pass by that Madras Central Jail, which is near the railway station, I think about the day. And he was not put in at a very young age. He was put in at when I am 71. He was put into jail when he was 68 or something. And he had health problems and all that those days. But he was a brave
person. But after independence, again you started?
No. The independence of India was on August 15th, 1947. Malayala Manorama's independence came only 15 weeks later. We could not report India's independence because we were still proscribed. The seal had, we have still kept that sealed door to show us and to also tell us that we should not be proud, we should be humble, we should think of it. teaches us to stand on the ground, and I've still kept the, it was from the old sealing wax with the mudra given on it. So it took, there was an, he was still the Diwan of Travancore even after independence, and he wanted an independent Travancore, independent of India, independent of Pakistan. And he sent an emissary to Pakistan also, you know, which my grandfather opposed. So if we, he said, if you agree, he told my uncle, K.M. Charyan, who was a professor of history in Madras Christian College, and who became the chief editor, third chief editor of Malayalam Manorama, told him, all what your father has to do is to agree to my independent Travancore, and I will give you back your license to print. My grandfather, anyway, he said, I've borne much. What is it? I'm not going to give up. So there was an incident, one member of the Revolutionary Socialist Party attacked this Diwan at a function in near Koilon, which is Kollam now, the place is Kollam, and tried to stab him, but the Diwan had an armor, so they chopped off his nose. And then his son, who was minister in the deputy minister of state or deputy minister in Panditji's government, came and took him back to Tamil Nadu, and we got our license immediately after that. When we started in 1947, November 29th, that was also an auspicious date, which was decided by one of our editorial colleagues' wife, who was a Nambudri lady. She looked at all this, and that's why, see, November 29th has no significance otherwise, you know. November 29th, 1947. When we started in Kottayam, when we reopened our office, there were snakes, the machines had gone, and no money, finished. We were reduced to poverty, absolute poverty. And my father, for instance, was studying for his BA when this all this happened. Then finally, what which we survived is we had some agricultural land in our, in Alappi district. So my grandfather took to a little bit of agriculture.
Your grandfather and father, and now you are the editor-in-chief. So it's a long journey. The and you have supported up 20 million. I think it's a record in Indian language.
Yeah,
also.
It's it is the circulation now of Malayalam Manorama audited circulation is 22.5. lakhs. That is the latest. Between us and the second in Kerala, there's quite a big gap. But they are a very respectable newspaper and all that.
But Mamaji, interesting thing which I wanted to know about you. In the age of 22, you joined as a reporter instead of becoming a, like a dynasty. Normally what happened is the business houses or the media houses, they just son come and take over as the editor or the manager or general manager, and they start working. How you come in picture and started as a reporter in Delhi, Times of India, then went to Britain, America, to work hard?
See, actually, Alok ji, 127 years for a newspaper is not a very old age, is not a very lengthy period, out of which 9 years we were closed down. 9 years we were closed down. I have come in, next year I complete 50 years in publications. And after my MA, which I did in medieval Indian history, I asked my father whether I could go to Columbia University for journalism. My father said, I don't have the money. I mean, we were really in very difficult times. When we restarted, we were the fifth newspaper in Kottayam town in Kottayam town. And with, see, the finances were really bad. I wanted to, see, first of all, I always found that many of the so-called journalists which we had used to say, owners are not professionals. I wanted to demolish that theory. First and foremost, I said, why can't, what prevents an owner from becoming professional? So I thought the first thing which should happen to me is, I should get, I mean, at the various discussions and all, I've heard people saying, oh, you don't have a degree, you don't have this thing, you don't have, you can't write. So I asked my father, can I go to Columbia University? He said, I don't have a, but he said, I'll get you a job.
Okay.
First, he got me a job. After my MA, I worked for in Malayala Manorama, Delhi Bureau, also for some time. And after that, I went and joined as a trainee journalist in Times of India, Bombay. Times of India, Bombay. And for me, all the time behind my back, was, I must prove myself as a journalist, first and foremost. I feel that I have a very strong language skill to write, to communicate, and to make other people understand what I'm writing. Some people write a lot of bombastic things. I know how to write to a person of 8th standard and make them understand. I don't go for very high. Main thing is, so I sat, I knew very well that Malayala Manorama is there. But I sat and started right from the beginning till the end to learn journalism, the traits. I learned newspaper law, art of writing, page layout. And when I was at Times of India, we used to bring out a lab paper called Training Times. Mr. Patanjali Sethi was in charge of our training. Mr. Vikram Rao, who became the working journalist president, was senior to me. And I think Mr. M.G. Akbar came later after I had left only. He was also, we all came up through the…
But M.G. Akbar later, I think he came there in 72 or something.
Yeah, I'm just saying, I think you were
there in 66 or something.
Yeah, yeah. I was there in 1966, I finished my MA, that's right. Training Times, each of the trainees is given a chance to be the editor to the thing.
Lab paper.
To do, bring up the lab paper, do everything. You have to do everything from writing the headlines to… I was fortunate to be the editor twice, which… I felt was one of the first times when I felt that, listen, there is, if you work hard, if you are dedicated, you can see Malayala Manorama. It was still a very, we had only about 100,000, 1 lakh circulation at the time. So I said, my ambition was to be a professional journalist and be a benevolent, what do you say, owner also. I felt that content is king. I have had an argument with the advertisement manager of our own office in Malayala Manorama once. He was encroaching into editorial space, not the present person, the person before. He was encroaching into editorial space with advertisement. I said, no, you should not do it. So he said, no, you have employed me to get advertisement. I again said, no. Then he suddenly turned around, whose side are you on? So I said, maybe it's my youth and all that, you know. I said, definitely not on your side. I'm on the side of the editorial.
This is the tradition of the British press, because you worked also in the London Times.
Yes, so I decided to be a working journalist. I decided, because working journalists used to say, Malik to kabhi professional ne ho sakte hain. Main to bola, ne, hum prove karenge. Main swayam work karke prove karenge ki Malik nahi hai, jisko bhi hard work professional journalist achieve kar sakte hain. And to be that, then I went to England. I worked in Cardiff, in Thomson Papers, in Cardiff, in Wales.
His fellowship, Thomson?
No. I went, last week I found my immigration papers to UK. I found that, so I have proof to show that I worked for 1 year in Thomson. So Thomson, Lord Thomson's papers, he had 192 newspapers, including the Times and the Sunday Times and papers all over the world. So I worked on his paper in Cardiff, the Western Mail, which was there.
You did some reporting?
Reporting. And my original offer letter is still there, which is sent to 2 INS building. Mammen, you have been selected to be a trainee journalist to work on the Western Mail for a period of 1 year on the Thomson organization. And my to work as an editorial is how I've got my immigration work permit also.
But it must be very difficult because of racism was there in those days, in the 70s.
See, the thing is, racism in India. See, sometimes I find we are also quite racist here in our country, you know. I mean, it's not racism, it's more out of snobbery and things and all that. We should be always down to earth in all our thinking. More than, as I said, if you know that you are confident of writing well, there's an old saying, of all the arts, the wise excel. Nature's masterpiece is writing well. So I felt I could write.
But you worked with a great editor.
I first worked on my news editor, Mr. John Humphreys in Cardiff, was a person who did not care whether I was black, blue, brown, ebony, mahogany, what color of my skin or anything. He just put you out onto the most difficult jobs, not out of any racism, because he also, I told him, you mold me. And he was a person, he was the original terrorist. I'd go, come back, he'd say, no, go back, go and get a quotation, proper this thing, and he'll throw it at me, and then I'll. And I felt it was good for me. And I went with how much? $7 from my pocket. I didn't have money. But there, one thing is, you get paid every week, you know.
Yeah.
So I survived, but learned the job. Survived and learned the job. Hard way. I never told any of them that I am also
owner of the paper,
I did. So that they will not give me any preferential treatment. I wanted it to be, like any other person.
So when you returned here,
Then I went to Sunday Times, where Mr. Harold Evans, yeah, who's the great editor. He was the great editor. He had just become editor. Lord Thompson had picked him up. He's still alive. And he on the Sunday Times, he was a great one. Now, Sunday newspaper used to start working from Wednesday onwards. So I got a chance to work with him. He came to Kottayam recently. He's married Tina Brown, who was the editor of New Yorker. And now he's moved to America. And he's brought out many volumes of books on newspaper editing, tight subbing, and how to write, layout, photography editing, everything, you know. So he's the person who really finally gave the finishing touches to my thing.
But professionally you can learn, Mamanji, but don't you feel that in the Western press, still we follow some extent the Western media, but the Indian language media, Malayala or any Indian language, Hindi or Gujarati, we have different priorities, and it should not be a very westernized journalism. Because you came here and Malayalam Manorama, that's why it's flourished, because you and your family members are the professionals. It's not a westernized newspaper.
No. Yeah, 100%
so
desi.
How you compare with these Western and
journalism? Now, I learned the ground rules of journalism from Times of India and from Mr. Harold Evans, John Humphreys. Just like the basic principles of this thing are same, you know, that you can learn it from, you know, learning it from Columbia or learning it on the ground force, it does not really. Then I went to America and worked on a regional newspaper to see how a small regional newspaper in Oklahoma City, nobody had even heard of Oklahoma City, but from England I went, I got a work permit again, and I started working. And my city editor, Bob Farquhar, he was not a terrorist like Mr. John Humphreys, but he was strict with me, and he helped me. And I'll tell you, it's 45 years since I have returned. Every New Year, he's retired also. Mm-hmm. He does not send me a card. He sends me a detailed letter of what is happening in the previous one. And I sit down and reply. 49 years unbroken. 49 years unbroken. See, in fact, I was surprised that I wanted to apply for the Nieman Fellowship to Harvard. Chanchal Sarkar Saab.
Press Institute.
Harold Evans and Bob Farquhar were the three persons who say. Then emergency happened, and then I could not pursue my application. See, they had trust in me that I could do. In England, first you're taught newspaper law. Then only you're allowed to handle a story. Then you must learn shorthand. Because shorthand, what you write is acceptable in the court also.
Yeah.
That is, I learned all that. Imagine me learning shorthand, sitting and learning typing. Typing I learned in Times of India. That's why now I'm pretty fast on my iPad and all that. People are surprised that. But it was in Oklahoma City, I would not say that the journalism was of that high standard as in England.
Two places
where newspaper reading is still, or may I'll say three places now, is one is in Britain, one is in Japan, and third is in Kerala, where newspaper is a print media is still the thing. Bill Gates said 2080 newspapers will close. From 2080, Manorama circulation and all the regional newspapers started growing. So people will say many things, but if you, there are certain principles to journalism. If you apply it properly, the right formula, it's right. Learn, write in simple language.
But you have so many editions and circulation. But how you come, because the three generations, no? Three generations read a newspaper. You are very rightly said that even in this digital age, people, young generation also want to read Malayalam. And their father, their mother. So how you do justice with all these? Because you said the content is the king. But to fulfill the ambitions or the expectation from the readers.
See, one thing which I set up when I came back, when I had 2 weeks, that time we didn't even have a news editor when I came back. We didn't have a news. One person every evening would sit and then he'll be the copy taster or some name. My father, like me, used to go and learn sitting in lectures, classes. Then he went to Columbia University for 3 months on an exchange program to learn journalism. So he managed to, he used to be actively involved in the Press Institute of India. He used to go and listen to Harold Evans speaking, Amitabha Chakravarti, all those old people in Press Institute, Chanchal Saab. And he was responsible for setting up the Asian Press Institute also. He used to attend as a student, and at the same time he started teaching journalism also. So when I came back, I said, we will be taking, we will start a training scheme, which I got the idea from Times of India and from my experience overseas. So we have, every year we take 2-3 batches of this. We appointed a person, editorial director, who was our editorial writer. We made him director of TKG Nair was the first one. Now Mr. Ubaidullah is our, we have a 3-hour written test with false numbers given, and there is central valuation. So even if I want to get my own son in, I will not be able to. And papers are set by various people. Sometimes one complete set is taken from one person, but we jumble it, false number. Then we have an interview. And then it's a 2-year training scheme where we have regular classroom. Now we are having on digital journalism we've gone on to. So we must not forget print. Everybody says print is going off, print is this thing. But so far, I have seen Malayala Manorama doing well. I never expected this sort of…
The pain is still like a sword.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah.
Fight with…
Yeah, pen is definitely… maybe the mouse is also coming, the mouse is there also, but… so, meanwhile…
But at the same time, Mamanji, I just want to… because this in Kerala, it's very difficult because you have communist, you have Congress, and the communal forces also very strong there. How you have to adjust with these people, and you have to must be have, as a resident writer or the, in a large circulation, you must be having more threats nowadays and earlier also. What kind of political pressure you
see there? It is true that we had some problems initially with the left, the Marxist Communist Party, because we feel that democracy, parliamentary democracy, rule of law, all these are paramount for a country. We had problem. They have attacked our presses. Under Mr. Nambudiripad's time, we attacked our presses. They've taken away our cameras, which we still have not got back and all. But those days have all gone, you know. They have realized that we are not attacking anybody. See, my uncle, Mr. K.M. Charan, was the chief editor. He said, and my father also used to say, don't write and hit somebody below the belt. At the same time, do not unnecessarily go on praising somebody. Yeah. That has no value. Go on saying, oh, you are very good. We take, and we don't take a very moralistic view. Now, for the instance, the Week magazine which we started, we are not giving advice, we are not, we are just simply putting forward the facts for people to read, and people are intelligent enough to decide. We used to, at one point, be known as a Congress paper.
Yeah.
And we learnt it the bitter way. In 1965 election or something, we put the old Congress symbol on the page one, showed how to vote for the Congress.
Oh.
I had not come in to the newspaper at that time. I told our editorial colleague, this is suicidal. And that assembly elections in Kerala, the Congress party got the lowest amount ever in the history of Kerala politics. 9 seats only. Everybody's got their own sense how to vote. We opposed the Kerala Congress because that we felt was a Christian party. My uncle, they burnt our newspapers. Now we are friendly with all of them. I am friendly with the Marxist people, Mr. Pinarayi Vijayan, Mr. Kodiyeri Balakrishnan, and of the Marxist Party. They are both Politburo members.
But you never compromise with anybody. I don't compromise.
No, I don't compromise. See, they used to say we were A.K. Antony's paper. Then they said we are Uman Chandi's paper. I said I am nobody's paper. I said, what is your political stand? People ask me. My political stand is Malayala Manorama political stand. To give good journalistic stuff to people, you know. If you give stale fish, nobody will. You give fresh fish, people will enjoy it. Everything should be. Give fresh vegetables. Give fresh everything. Everything should be nothing. And now we are. I am friendly with even the many of the BJP leaders.
I remember Atal Bihari Vajpayee when
yes.
in Editors Guild also and yes. otherwise also the Malayalam Manorama.
When we, in fact, if you remember, Alok ji, that Atal Bihari Vajpayee called us for tea at Panchavati. The first, we were the first to have that. He gave us a tea and we were able to revive the Editors Guild. And it was, I'm friendly with them. And the Kerala RSS leaders also I am friendly. Now for instance, Mr. Mukundan, P.P. Mukundan, who's now, he and I have been friends for 40 years, you know. Now if somebody says, oh, you're friendly with BJP, I cannot deny that I'm not, I have to be friendly with all.
Everybody.
Not only in politics, in cultural life and this thing. There are certain things. Now for instance, returning of this awards.
The writers.
Writers awards. See, the academy is not the government. Academy is supposed to be an independent. I don't think returning the award. You can do it like in Japan, for instance. Put an armband, work one day extra. I will bring out one more poem, new poetry. But returning this, is, to me, it is not right. You know, it is, because when you receive it with great distinction, you don't throw it back. If I come to your house for dinner and you give me dinner, I must accept it.
Yes.
Then I can't, after 10 years, say, no, I don't like, I don't approve of Alok ji. I'm going to vomit it back. No, that is not
right. But Mamaji, maybe you must be feeling that in Kerala and in other states also, there was a threats of communal forces time to time, maybe.
Yeah.
It's not the first time it's happening.
Yeah.
Earlier also, and especially the Malayalam Manorama or the newspapers, or the writers also, when they feel something unpleasant, hatred in the society, and sometimes in the ruling party, when Shiv Sena, I can name them, in the earlier days, in Maharashtra also, they attacked channels, newspaper houses. Even I remember in Malayalam Manorama office also, once there was attack by Shiv Sena.
Shiv Sena.
So, don't you feel that
they came in, they came
writers
in,
and journalists should speak something against those?
Definitely, definitely. We should see. I belong to the minority community. I'm a Syrian Christian from Kerala. We have been Christians in India since 52 AD. We have been Christians before the Europeans became Christians. Indian Christianity is as old as Christianity itself, or 2000 years. We have been. I'm a believer in God. I'm a believer in one God, the goodness of God, I believe. I am not a fanatic. My friends are of every religion, Muslims, Hindus, Parsis, Sikhs. See, before my MA exam in Delhi, I went with my friend Rishpal Singh to the Gurudwara to pray that I should pass the exam, you know. No, but I went to the Gurudwara with the Rishpal. Rishpal Singh taught me a lot about Sikhism. I went and I have great respect for it. I have been to the Golden Temple 3 times. And when I went to the Golden Temple, before my son's marriage, I went to the Golden Temple to pray. So you can, where you find peace, there is God. So you don't have to get worked up that, I don't think, see, there was occupation from Mughal and all. Still, the basic fabric of India is still there, so we are not threats. And I don't think even the minority community, other minority communities are a threat to our nation. They will see. In fact, I support every other thing. And I go to temple. I cannot go inside, but I stay near a temple.
But that's why it's our job of the professional journalists and the writers. They should also write, speak freely.
Yes.
What independence, what we, our forefathers did.
Yes, definitely. I think you should write clearly and say, be quiet, strong and fearless in expressing. I remember Mohan Ram, my old friend, he used to be a big leftist, we used to work in the INS building together. And he used to say, be a fearless editor. That means don't fear grammar or anything like that. So he used to talk about don't fear grammar and write. So he used to always say fearless editor is a person who has no fear of grammar. But we should always speak our mind. We should always speak. See, I became the editor of Manorama after 22 years of working.
Yeah.
From where was my posting? It was not to Kottayam. When I returned from England and America and all this, I thought I will be sent back to Delhi to work as a special. My uncle, the sage, who was responsible for bringing up Malayalam Manorama again after the closure, He told me, I'm called Rajan at home. That is my pet name, Rajan. And he said, Rajan, you've just come. I went to call on him as soon as I came. And my parents had come, and the senior editor was also there. I said, you just come, you seem to have lost a lot of weight and all that, working hard. I said, no, it's just that I had. So he said, I said, yeah, I'm being sent back to Delhi, I presume. So he said, no, you're going to Calicut. Calicut. We had just started.
They worked in London, Delhi, Mumbai, and Calicut.
I said, Calicut. I was a bachelor. So I said, what did I told him? How long should I go for? He said, go for 6 months, because our resident, our city editor there has transferred himself to Trivandrum, and so you need to go there. And we started in 1966, our second edition in Calicut. So I, so 1970, January 7th, I went to Calicut as a bachelor and stayed in the PWD rest house. Every time a minister came, I had to vacate. Then go out, stand at the gate, come back, and but I just started working. And that 6 months became 10 years and 2 months. 10 years. I got married in 1970. And those 10 years were a very glorious time for me, because it is a new unit, so you could implement what you had. I was the person who changed the new, the before used to sit on tables, the chief sub used to sit there, and others used to sit around and all that. We used to, I changed the model of this, and we were able to fearlessly report. Occasionally from head office, old timers would say, no, you're straying off the path. And layout we did, we got prizes for layout, the Calicut edition. I was young, I was 25, 20, so I was able to 25 and a half, do it my way. My father never told me, don't experiment. He gave me that license. It is, I never had any problem. And we were going to the lion's den and fighting the lion. Our competitor, Matrubhumi, that was their headquarters. We were going from Kottayam to Calicut. And we went with an old press, rented building, all those things. Entire cost was only 2 lakhs those days. That was the old press. We bought furniture worth 36,000. All those bills and all are still kept there to show them. So we started there. But my job was made easier by Mr. K.R. Chumar, who was a giant of a colleague of mine. He, with his lack, aim was to have 1 lakh circulation in the old British Malabar, which he achieved. So I just had to go and continue the good work which he had to do. Similarly, say, going back to your original question, see, I said, I have also been only a part, because the foundation was very good. I am the 5th chief editor in 127. The first 4 have done enormous amount of work. Then there is our teamwork within Malayala Manorama. Technically, I am supposed to be the number one. But I consult our editorial director, who came as a cartoonist to Malayala Manorama, Mr. Thomas Jacob. He came at the age of 23 or something. He has put in 54 years. So I respect his professional capabilities, and I, in my mind, I report to him, you know. I don't have to report to anybody, but you have to have somebody as your editorial boss, you know. I'm still too much of an editorial. I have got the designation of chief editor and managing director. I am perhaps one of the worst managing directors the country can ever produce, you know, I mean. But I think I am a fairly good chief editor. And I am able to motivate. My main job now is to motivate and to see that our reporters, our editors, our writers bring out the best. We give them all the facilities. Now, previously when Prime Minister and all used to go abroad, they used to take journalists. The invitation always comes to us. I want to tell you, Alok ji, not once has the management of Malayala Manorama gone on a trip with the Prime Minister or the President or anything. We have always given it to our colleagues so that they will have an exposure. They will see, they are doing really the bulk of the work now.
Amanji, we will continue our very interesting phase of your journey, and especially after this, the editors you followed, how the new challenges in the new media, television also, you are in the broadcasting also, the Malayalam Manorama is there. So, hum is baatcheet ko jaari rakhenge ek chote se break ke baad. हम बातचीत कर रहे हैं मलयालम मनोरमा के प्रधान संपादक और मैनेजिंग डायरेक्टर मामन मैथ्यू जी से. बातचीत को हम आगे जारी रखते हैं. मामन जी, हाउ यू फील द न्यू चैलेंजेस ऑफ द टेलीविजन, बिकॉज नाउ यू हैव आल्सो द मनोरमा, मलयालम मनोरमा चैनल, टीवी चैनल्स, न्यूज चैनल्स, एंड रियली पीपल थिंक दैट प्रिंट मीडिया इज गोइंग डाउन एंड द मोर पॉपुलर टेलीविजन, थ्रू टेलीविजन यू कैन रीच टू द मासेस. How much challenge you face, or you feel the challenge is there?
See, first, I don't want to overreact to the threat, threat for the print media, because Hindi newspapers are doing very well. Hindi newspapers are doing, Daily Jagran is doing well, Rajasthan Patrika is doing well, Bhaskar. Then Dainik Bhaskar is doing. Bhaskar is doing very well. They've all. They're doing very well.
Malayalam. Hindustan Times publications.
Yes, yes. Hindustan is doing. It's very good. It's very good. They're all doing very well. And if you see the last six-month ABC period, you will notice that the language, Indian language newspapers and Hindi papers are doing better
than the English.
Than the English media, you know. The Indian language, see, this time our growth was little low. We had only a 17,000 growth, but you know, what is our circulation? Huge circulation, you know. We have got 42 publications from preschool up to a highbrow magazine called Bhasha Bhoshni, which was started by a founder. See, whatever our founder started is still there. He also started a residential school for girls in those days, you know, which is still running. Running very well. He donated his own land, he donated everything, you know. So we have got 42 publications now. From we've got in one, we've got Magic Pot, Akkad Bakkad, we have started in Hindi, and we have
Vanita also.
Vanita in Malayalam is the highest in any magazine, not only weekly, fortnightly, that is, Vanita is a fortnightly. Hindi Vanita is totally different. It's not just a copy of this thing. The contents are. See, we have yearbooks in five languages: English, Hindi, Tamil, Malayalam, and Bengali. Yeah. And in Bengali. And this is the 50th year of the English yearbook. I think the English yearbook has actually brought a lot of fame for Malayala Manorama. My father was known as K.M. Mathew, chief editor, Manorama yearbook rather than of the Manorama publication. Yearbook is now, we are doing exceedingly well. Everybody who's, and it's really top class, cheap and top class. Cheap, I mean, we keep the price low, you know. Bhasha Bhoshni was started by a founder, and that time it had only 12,000 copies. It is still got only 12,000 copies, but that is 12,000 dedicated, committed readers of it. Still 12,000 only. And so we should not hope. But at the same time, you should not be blind to the digital area. We have not panicked, we have not pressed the panic button so far. The Week is doing well.
It's a supplement. Your TV news channel is supplementing the newspaper.
The management team consisting of my younger brother, Philip Mathew, then my youngest brother, Jacob Mathew, our whiz kid in technology matters is K.M. Charyan's grandson, George Jacob, my son, Amit, my nephew, my son is Jayant, Amit, my nephew, Riyadh, my nephew, and Harsha, who's also my nephew. We form a management team. We've delegated everything very well. Now, we first went to channel. We first started news channel. We become number one in that. Entertainment, Asianet is there because it is owned by Star. So, we are doing well. Then we started FM radio. FM radio, you'll be surprised, is run by my nephew Amit. It's called Radio Mango. We have got channels, stations. He's went and learnt this in Australia working for a company called Austereo. My son worked for Fox TV in California with Murdoch. So we have not even parachuted any of our children also from on top.
You mentioned the word Murdoch. Yeah. I just want to know, like Times of India also shifted offices in Delhi. Yeah. Why you have not come to national capital to become more strong, more rich in the country?
See, now the new technological age, you don't have to be at a particular place. Straits Times of Singapore, you can sit in Australia and also edit it. You know, technology is so fast. You don't have to be physically present. And I feel coming to the national capital, we will tend to become a little bit political. You know, none of us are interested to be in politics. I think a good journalist, a good editor should listen to everybody, to all political, from the minority communal forces to the majority, everything we must listen. But personally, one should not be a forerunner member of some party, and we should not. Actually, we've all been offered some sort of
things. Rajya Sabha and all. People used to talk about that, why you are not coming to Rajya Sabha. proposals about.
See, I would prefer to sit in the press gallery and report this thing than be a Rajya Sabha and not know anything what is happening. For me, I'm a student of politics, definitely, but I'm totally apolitical regarding this thing. For me, there is no. The New York Times says all the news that's fit to be printed, you can print. And so I feel every newspaper owner's first weakness is to try and cozy up to some Congress, to some party, and become a Rajya Sabha member, and then you lose your identity. If I join Congress or BJP or Marxist or Muslim League member, I'm sure or Akalis or whatever, become a member. They will never judge Malayala Manorama
as
an independent. They'll say, ah, Mammen Mathew, he's a member of a political party. This is, it took us a long time to shed that Congress image. You know. Now people know that we are.
So who are your role model? Like where S. Nihal Singh was there, Pran Chopra was there. Number of haters, we have worked also with some.
Yes,
Times of India, Shankarji was there, Rilal Jain was there.
Definitely. One editor is my guru itself, is Mr. Sir Harold Evans. There he's really brilliant. In India, I have really some favorites like Mr. Pran Chopra, Mr. Inder Malhotra is there.
Mr. Nihal Singh,
yes, I will say why. Mr. Nihal Singh is definitely, I have named my grandson Nihal.
Oh.
He's 11 years old. I've named him Nihal because I've known Mr. Nihal Singh for almost half a century, you know, and I feel he's a very good chap. I knew him when he was in Statesman, and I felt there's a good style of his writing, you know. Then of course B.G. Varghese is there, who was a serious type of, he was not the entertaining type, but he was always straightforward, this thing and all that. And
even Ajit Bhattacharya and Rajendra Mathur also, you.
Yeah.
Rajendra
Mathur, I had a memorial lecture in his. He was one person who, even Mr. Nikhil Chakravarti, Mr. Nikhil Chakravarti came and inaugurated our Koilon office. See, all our offices were inaugurated not by politicians or chief ministers. We always got an editor from Delhi to come. Our Trivandrum office was inaugurated by Kushwant Singh. H.K. Dua Sahib was inaugurated at Trichur office. Nikhilda, you know, and I liked Nikhilda's, you know, he stood by his by the mainstream paper, and he was able to. His political views and was not the thing, but he could have done much better, you know, if he had been more brave in that. Nikhilda was definitely one of the persons whom I admired, and a lot of editors.
Political leaders also, you must be having a lot of friends and enemy also. Can you give some incident when people used to pressurize you or praising you?
See, I'm friends with a lot of politicians, even at the national level. I do not know Mr. Amit Shah, but I have had a meeting with the Prime Minister. Sonia ji has been extremely nice to.
Mrs. Gandhi or Rajiv Gandhi must have visited you.
Rajiv Gandhi was. Indira ji was my father's contemporary, almost my father's age. Indira ji would have been 98.
She must have visited your office in Kerala sometime?
Yes. She's come to our office in Kottayam. Yeah. Come to our head office in Kottayam. See, and lot of people have come. People will try and influence you as, because that's politicians, yes, are, they try to influence. How best we withstand the pressure is our test of integrity, you know. Whether I can, I do not accept any presents from anyone. Even from my colleagues, I do not. Some of my colleagues who were retired and gone and to Gulf or America. They bring. I say nothing. Even if they bring a box of, a packet of tea, I will take it to the evening editorial conference, and we all our editors will sit and have it. And so, it is. There have been pressures. Manorama did not succumb to the pressure of the Diwan of Travancore, and we paid the price. My grandfather had only to nod his head and say, okay, we would have not been closed down for 9 years, and we were penniless, Alokji, penniless, everything which we had. My grandfather had a bank also. So the Diwan thought the bank was financing the newspaper, so he closed the bank first. May had an artificial run on the bank, but still Manorama came back. In history of the world, no newspaper has been closed for 9 years and come back with this thing. I don't think it is said in our horoscope, but we have come back by the grace of God and our people. We did not have money to buy newsprint for the next day. Pressure. Pressure, they will put pressure. The rulers will always put pressure. How well we must not be rude, but how well we answer and logically explain to them that it is can't. There are certain people who come to me and say, no. I say, no. It is very difficult to say no, but I say no. And I do not do anything out of the way to harm them also. Yeah. I don't harm them. See, the Marxists had a feeling that my grandfather is wrongly quoted as saying that apparently he told one of his communist, those days Communist Party of India only, it was under, my grandfather told P.T. Punnus, a communist leader, who used to come and meet my grandfather. P.T. Punnus spread a rumor saying that K.C. Mammen Mathew said, if the communists come to power in Kerala, me and my 9 children will consume poison and die.
Oh.
Nothing like that was said. What was said to P.T. Punnus was, if your party, this was before the MS Namudri pardon, if your party comes, you will stop me from reading the books which I like. I am a reader. My grandfather used to underline everything what he used to read. You will stop me from reading books which I like. And when you stop me from reading the books which is like, it is better to commit suicide than, that is what. Anyway, this statement is always used against us by Deshabhimani, the Marxist paper. Mm-hmm. And they have written series against us. Series against us and wrongly. But I'll tell you, of late, Deshabhimani has also become professional.
On the professional issue, the really new challenge of paid news, which in Editors Guild, in press councils also we are talking about it. But how you feel this, this problem of the paid news, and how the media can counter it?
See, I went, Alok ji, Malayala Manorama stand on paid news is very clear. Crystal clear, very crystal clear. If Manorama is against paid news, if you agree to paid news, it is better the journalists give up the pen or the mouse or whatever it is and sit at home and enjoy. paid. We are, see, journalism is a mission. Paid news is an easy way out. See, there were so many easy way outs for my grandfather. He did not. He always took the hard line. Always took the hard line. And see, paid news, no. That is not journalism. Paid news is not journalism. How can it be called news? You can call it advertorial or something, you know, but you can't call it news. News is impossible.
The corporate sponsored editorial content also, there is an issue nowadays in media, especially some newspapers are following. It's a corporate sponsored content. The newspaper in the name of the editorial content.
I was addressing the St. Xavier's School of Journalism. Incidentally, we've also got a college for mass comm, college for journalism. Outlook has rated it as the 8th best in the country. I was addressing the St. Xavier's School or College of Journalism students in Kottayam. They asked me, with all this, aren't you tempted to take advertisement? Yes, temptation is there. How well you resist it is your character, you know. See, temptation is there. Everybody has a price. Maybe I may not take, but I would not like my name to be on the masthead of a paper taking paid news. I will sit at home. I'm not even so keen that I should complete 50 years or something. If I find that we are not following that sacred trust which my grandfather wrote and gave it to his son, which I will read it out to you, if I'm not able to live up to my own expectations, leave alone what others think, unless I... It is better that I sit at home and spend time with my wife, my son and my grandchildren and my granddaughter and all that, and be happy and watch the... See, I must also tell you, we are only the temporary custodians. You have to make way for much more professional. But we should not see politicians strive to bribe you with money also.
Yeah.
Corporate houses also try to bribe you with money. How you must have your intellectual integrity. Your integrity should be, that should be there. If you are have no principles and just go on, it's not worth running. It's, you go and change your profession, you go into hoteliering or something else, which is also hospitality, but you don't make much of money there.
So in conclusion, what you would like to say for the future of media, including Malayalam Manorama, but for the next generation, not only for Malayalam Manorama, but the whole new generation of the media, what will be your message, like a editorial views?
First and foremost, I would say, be committed and dedicated to the profession of journalism. Certain sort, that commitment, if you have, that will take you a long way. Now nobody says that Mammen Mathew, an owner, is unfit to run Malayala Manorama. I have demolished the theory that owners cannot be professional. From any parameter you look, that theory is gone. Now see, I was elected as the president of the Editors Guild, and I was also elected as the president of the Indian Newspaper Society. And the Editors
Even
Guild.
Writers, you are the trustee of the writers.
Yeah, writers. I'm the first Indian, 151 years. Sushma ji, she called and congratulated at that time. And I did not complete my full term because my father passed away, and I did not. My term would have finished only in 2017, and they were paying me per month. Everything was fine. But I thought that my first commitment is to Malayala Manorama. I have very little social activity. I do my work, come home, and I'm. Sunday is one day when I just relax and think. But in the evening, that itch is there to call the associate editor and ask him, what is going on, you know. And last week I forgot to call him because of some other problem. He asked me on Monday, sir, you did not call me yesterday, what happened? So leave no doubt into people's mind, that your dedication, that you will be till the last moment. Stand by them. You should stand by them. If the facts are sacred, you'll stand by your journalist. See, I think it is premature to write off the print media. Please do not be in a hurry to write off the print media. We will, though we have our eggs in various other baskets and all that, print media brings us everything. It is there. It is there. I am not against the digital media or the electronic media or multimedia. We get, see, now on my mobile I can get my television, this thing, everything is there, you know, online is there, everything is there. But we should see that the media, if our country has a media which changes, succumbs, bends, crawls, then we don't have much of a future. We must be upright, straightforward, and be quite humble about it. Why? In fact, I got a very distinguished award, which you may not realize. The Kesari newspaper gave me the Balagangadhar Tilak Award as a 1 lakh rupees. That is one of the things which touched me very much when I went there.
With the tradition,
I went there, I participated, my wife and I participated in the puja at the temple. And Tilakji was for me a very big hero.
Yes.
And they have given the award only 5 times in so many, 100 and so many years, you know. And the following year, Janmabhoomi's editor, we started life together.
Kundan Lal Vyas
and I started life together. Both of us on scooters here in Delhi.
Yeah.
He got the. I'm not claiming anything, but I did recommend his name. So I'm just saying, even people with whom I have no other. They respect me as an editor. They don't respect me as a businessman.
So I hope Malayala Manorama will also be very successful in future.
Yeah,
and the future of the media is very bright. Kalam Gawah Hai, Gawah Rahegi. Strong Hai, Strong Rahegi. Mammen ji, thank you very much.
Thank you very much. Very kind of you. Thank you.
Nice talking.
Thank you.